Welcome back to the Science of Car Care. Today, we're talking about surfactants. You can find them all around us in all types of applications, from household cleaning to car care to even food applications. In this video, we're going to be talking about surfactants, what they are, and how they're used in car care. So what is a surfactant? A surfactant is a chemical which breaks the surface tension of a fluid. Most commonly in car care, that fluid is water. Surface tension is essentially the force that makes water form a droplet versus wet out onto surfaces. So practical applications that demonstrate what surface tension is, for example, when you drop a water droplet onto a hydrophobic surface onto your car. It forms these nice spherical beads, which then will hopefully run off due to the hydrophobics of the underlying coating. Additionally, you get some unique properties in nature, such as little tiny bugs that can actually float on the surface of water, and that surface tension is what allows those bugs to float instead of sink, even though their density typically exceeds one, so it should actually fall down and sink and break through the water, but the surface tension allows them to stay and kind of walk on water, so to speak. To that end, you can also throw a really thin razor blade onto the surface of water and tends to float rather than sink, even though the density of that steel is heavier than water. So surfactants literally mean surface active agents, meaning they can actually modify the surface tension of different fluids. Surfactants themselves have both a polar part and a non-polar part, which you might remember from a previous YouTube video that we shot where we discussed polarity of water and non-polarity of water in terms of coatings, but now we're talking about surfactants, which have both of those parts within the molecule. You may have heard the concept in chemistry class that like dissolves like, meaning polar things like to dissolve polar things, non-polar things like to dissolve non-polar things. One of the practical applications of surfactants is that it allows you to dissolve unlike fluids together. So for example, if you have an oil, for example, on your car that's soiling the surface, a surfactant will allow you to kind of dissolve that oil into water. Because water is more abundant and we wash all of our cars with water, that's a very practical way to use a surfactant. So there are a couple different types of surfactants that you might hear about. One type is called an ionic surfactant, means it has a literal positive or negative charge on it. These types of surfactants are often used in detergents, so laundry detergent, a really strong car wash soap might have an ionic surfactant. Hand soaps tend to have ionic surfactants, things like that. So there's also non-ionic surfactants, which don't have any charge on them. However, they still kind of have a polar part and a non-polar part still on the molecule. These are a little bit more mild than ionic surfactants, but have unique properties like really strong wetting abilities, which we'll talk about in a little bit. Additionally, there's one kind of third surfactant called an amphoteric surfactant, means it actually literally has both a negative and positive charge both on the molecule, even though the molecule is still net neutral. These are pretty useful in niche applications, one of which is to actually stabilize foam in car care, which is useful to create this really strong lubricious foam so that you don't scratch your car when you start to wash it. So one of the key functions of surfactants in car care is to actually penetrate and wet out dirt and road grime when you wash your car. So when it rains, for example, and there's no surfactants around, water tends to simply hit the surface of your car, wet into little droplets, and then slide off when you start to drive. When you wash your car with a surfactant in a car soap, the car soap allows the fluid to actually completely wet the surface of your car, even if it's slightly hydrophobic, and contains the dirt. So the surfactants allow that fluid to really encapsulate those dirt particles by penetrating and stabilizing it. And so it lifts it into the solution and allows you to wash that soil away. And that's why rain doesn't clean your car. It needs a surfactant to help it out. So we've talked a lot about surfactants and how they help you clean your car, but surfactants are also used in many other applications within car care. Take drying aids, for example. Drying aids use surfactants to prevent water spots. Water spots, at the end of the day, are simply water droplets which allow to dry on your car, concentrating inorganic particulates that are kind of in groundwater to essentially dry onto the car and actually stick really strongly to your paint. Drying aids actually break the surface tension of water through the use of surfactants so that as you dry it, those little droplets of water are allowed to actually spread and wet so that it's easier to dry your car off. Surfactants are also found in modern quick detailing products, and they're in there for a couple of different reasons. The first reason is, of course, you're trying to put hydrophobic materials like silicone oils and waxes into water. Like we said earlier, like doesn't like to dissolve like. So surfactants allow the oils like silicone and waxes to actually be stabilized and dissolved into water. The second reason you might need surfactants in a coating, like a quick detailer, is that it actually helps that coating completely wet out. And so what that allows you to do is prevent things like streaking, because streaking at the end of the day is really just really thin lines of non-volatile materials like silicone. So if you have a wetting agent in there that breaks the surface tension of silicone onto the surface of your car, those wetting agents will actually help it to wet out and minimize the amount of streaking that you see. So while surfactants really help us dissolving hydrophobics into a water solution, water-based coatings tend to be a little less durable than their solvent-based counterparts. The reason for that is surfactants don't really evaporate and they don't really go away. So when you apply a quick detailer to your car, the surfactants pretty much stick there alongside any hydrophobic material that you've applied. So when it rains, the surfactant can kind of help resolubilize the hydrophobics back into the water phase and rinse off when the rain does. One of the ways you can counteract the surfactant still remaining on the surface when you apply a quick detailer is you can put slightly more reactive silicone polymers into the formulation so that it cross-links and makes it a little bit more difficult for those hydrophobics to wash away. So at the end of the day, surfactants really make our job a lot easier as detailers. They allow us to clean a little bit better, more easily, give us stronger detergents. They allow us to dissolve oils and hydrophobics into water solutions, and they actually really help us with any type of elimination of streaks and with drying. You might also find surfactants in wheel cleaners, the iron remover, interior detailers, water-based trim shines, and all-purpose cleaners, but you won't find it in invisible glass. I hope this video was helpful in elucidating some of the confusion around surfactants. If you were confused by anything we talked about, leave a comment. If there's any other topics that you'd like to see discussed, also leave a comment. And thank you for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.